Hello everyone. In the last we discussed about the types of the switches, that is mechanical and electronic switch. You know very well, in this unit you are going to about you are knowing the solid state switching circuits. The meaning of the solid state switching circuit, that is we are from a switching circuits with the help of the solid state devices, and a well-known solid state devices is transistors. So let's have a introduction to the electronic switches. The electronic switches, they are generally made up of transistors. But how transistor can work as a switch? How transistor can work as a switch? As we know very well, the transistor can use as a switch by driving it back and forth between the cutoff and saturation. See the circuit diagram over here. The circuit diagram over here will be indicates that how transistor can work as a switch. In the first figure, if we can say that if the input voltage applied to the transistor, the input voltage applied to the transistor, that is at the base, if my base voltage is sufficient negative or enough negative, that makes my transistor is in cutoff. When transistor is in cutoff, then ultimately no collector current will flow from the load. No collector current will flow from the load. That is, ultimately we can say that IC is equal to zero. See in the first figure, when you are not applying any input, or input is enough negative to max the base of the transistor, or input junction is in reverse bias, so ultimately there will be no current will flow from the RC, so there will be no load across the RC, so entire supply voltage will appear across the collector emitter junction. That is, we can say that the VC is equal to VCC, where IC is equal to zero, that is transistor is in cutoff, that ultimately there will be no voltage drop across the RC. If there is a no voltage drop across the RC, so ultimately all the voltage, that is all the voltage means the entire supply voltage, will appear across the collector emitter junction, that is VC is equal to VCC. So we can say that when IC is equal to zero, VC is equal to VCC. And this condition is very much similar to the switches open. Switches open. Let's have a second. The second condition will be indicates that when the input of the transistor is positive, so ultimately transistor will start to conduct. And its collector current will be increases and become saturation. So all the supply voltage will appear across the RC, that is ICRC, product of the ICRC. So voltage drop across the collector emitter junction is ideally zero. So we can say that the IC is equal to IC saturation is equal to VCC upon RC, where VC is equal to zero. That is, we can say that the saturation condition, and which is similar to the switch is closed. So whenever the transistor is in cutoff, IC is equal to zero and VC is equal to VCC. That is, we can say the switch is open or off. Switch is open or an off state. Whenever the transistor is in saturation, the IC saturation is equal to VCC upon RC, and VC is equal to zero. That is, we can say the transistor is in saturation, that is equivalent to switch is closed or on state. This is what we can say the load line analysis, where point B indicates the cutoff and point A indicates the saturation. Line joining these two will called as a load line. So we can say that what is the conclusion of this? Conclusion is this: a transistor can behave as a switch. Under the proper conditions. The proper condition means a transistor will drive between cutoff and saturation. As shown in the DC load line. So, what are the advantages of the electronic switches? We are not preferring mechanical switches. There will be a number of advantage, number of limitation of the mechanical switches. Over there, there will be a number of advantage of the electronic switches are there. First and most important advantage of the electronic switch is that it has no moving parts. Hence, if there is a no moving parts, there will be no problem with the wear and the tear, and it gives you a noiseless operation. We know very well the transistors are very small in size and very light. So we can say that the switch they made up by using the transistors are smaller in size and weight. As it is a solid state device, it gives you a trouble-free service. Transistors are very cheap. So we can say that it's cheaper than the other switches, and maintenance is also very little. Very sparse speed of the operation, very fast speed of the operation. That is generally, we can say that exactly 109 operations per second. Where mechanical switches are only 5 operations per second. So there is a huge difference between these two. So this is the advantage of the electronic switches. How transistor can work as a switch? The transistor is a work as a switch when it is a drive between the cutoff and saturation. Let's have a switching action of the transistors. See the output characteristics of the transistor will be shown over here. The load line is drawn over here, in which there will be number of points are going given over here. The off state, on state, and the active region. That is, A is called as off state, B is called as a on state, and between them they are called as a active region. So in short, we can say is that this indicates the cutoff, this is indicates the saturation, and between these two we call as an active region. Let's move first to the off region. When transistor is an off. The transistor is an off whenever you give the input to the base is either a zero or a negative. That is, we can say is that the base current is equal to zero. So ultimately there will be a no collector current will flow, or we can say that very small collector current will flow, that is called as a leakage current. And that is indicated by ICEO, or the when IB is equal to zero, IC is equal to ICEO. The value of ICO can be obtained from the characteristics if we know the VC. Then what will be the power loss? We know very well the P is equal to VI. A power loss is equal to output voltage into output current. So we can say is that in this condition, the output current, that is leakage current, is very, very, very small. That is, we can say is that the negligible. A negligible current, ICO. But if you assume the sum voltage, then the power loss is equal to VCC into ICO, but ICO is very, very, very small, output voltage that is VC is equal to VCC, and output current that is ICU. So value of ICU is very small. That is, we can say is that the value of power loss is quite small. Value of power loss is quite small, small in the off condition. That is means it has very high efficiency as a switch when it is in the off condition. When it is in the off condition. Similarly, when the transistor will start to conduct and reach to the saturation, we can say is that the VC is equal to zero or negligible, and IC is equal to IC saturation. As far as the this equation, the power loss is equal to output voltage into output current. The output voltage that is VCE is very, 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 very small, and output current is saturated, IC saturated. So we can say is that the IC saturated is equal to VCC minus VNE upon RC. Or we can say is that power loss is equal to output voltage into output current. So whenever the switch is in on condition or transistor is in saturation, the output voltage is nearly equal to knee voltage. And value of this knee voltage is quite small. So we can say is that, so that we can say is that it has low power loss in the on condition also. So it has a high efficiency in off state, it has high efficiency in on state, because in the both state, in the first state, the leakage current is small. In the second stage, the output voltage is very small. So we can say that in the both stages, it has a low efficient, a high efficiency for the power loss. So active region, that is, we can say is the region between saturation and cutoff, that is indicated by the AB. The region AB is called as an active region. In this condition, we can say is that the transistor is unstable, because it is a transient state of the transistor in which the transistor can change its state from off to on or on to off. Or we can say is that in this active region, the collector current will be increases from the leakage current to saturation current, and from the saturation current to leakage current. That's why this is the unstable states of the transistors. So these are the three stage: on stage, off stage, and the active stage of the transistor. So what will be the conclusion of this? The conclusion of transistor as a switch will be derived like that, where in the active region, transistors operate as a linear amplifier, because there is a small change in the input current, there will be a large change in the output current. So we can say that it is work as an input. And saturation region, the transistor behave as a short circuit. Transistor behave as a short circuit, which means the VC is approximately the zero and IC is maximum. And value of IC is limited by the collector resistor RC. Whereas in the cutoff region, is behave as an open circuit, because in this, the ideally IC is equal to zero and VC is equal to supply voltage VCC. So we can say is that a transistor is in saturation and cutoff can behave as a switch when its saturation states corresponding to the close of the switch and the cutoff is corresponding to the opening of switch. So this way, the transistor can work as a switch when it will be operated between cutoff and saturation. The saturation is corresponding to the closure of the switch, and the cutoff is corresponding to the opening of the switch. So this is about the electronic switches. Thank you.